food you'll be served every night that you come up here. We've had everything from steak to cinnamon rolls. So
you had that meatloaf sandwich last game, if I'm correct.
We don't want to get left out tonight.
Right now we have the introductions going underway for both teams. Again, starting five for the Tigers. It's going to be Brock Butler, the Soak-Up Twins, Marquise Jones, and Mitchell Dre. It's a five that Coach Huseman feels really comfortable with. They're all veteran players, Kent. And so far, they've had a lot of success on the court.
Yeah, and three of them are juniors. The Soak-Up boys are the only seniors that start. And those boys have been playing together for a long time. So it's five kids that when you put them on the floor, they can play the game. And a lot of times, you don't have to use a timeout because all of them are basketball smart. And they can make the changes and adjustments on the floor without calling a timeout. So it's nice to have those five kids in your starting lineup.
We've really seen that so far this season. The Soak-Up Twins, their on-the-court IQ is just off the charts. If there's a tough play or a mental lapse, it's not going to be made by them. They're always on top of their game mentally, and they're always prepared to play at the top of their abilities. Marquise Jones is getting introduced here, and I'm not at the veteran status of broadcasting, Kent, like you and John Kuehns. I still can't time the national anthem out perfectly. I had to come back in the middle of Brian Cachet's, my neighbor's beautiful rendition of the national anthem. And one day I'll get it down, though. One day, I promise.
Take time.
It's like basketball. You got to practice and get good at it.
That's right.
Both teams are now done with the introductions, and they're going to do their last-second celebrations and then warm-ups. And then we're underway. Looks like the Panthers are all set to go. It's going to be a difficult game so far. Already looking at the court for the Tigers. The big men for the Panthers, very dominating. Justin Ball, 6'8", 250. He looks bigger from up here.
Yeah, he does. He looks real big.
And Jeff Ross, we saw all pregame. I told John, I think he's probably going to have a big game. He was hitting a lot of his warm-up shots, and he wasn't taking the normal easy ones. He was taking the hardest ones he could. Coach Huseman wants to say one last words of advice for his team before they come out to the court. And here we go. We're going to get underway for the third conference matchup for the Iowa Wesleyan Tigers.
You know, sometimes you wonder when you play the Soak-Up boys if people get confused on who they're supposed to be guarding.
I think they do that intentionally. They wear 22, 23. They wear all the same gear, and they have the same haircut. It's very confusing for opposing defenses. Here comes the tip, and it's going to be won by the Tigers. And it was Mitch Dre tipping it out to Steven Soak-Up. Michael Soak-Up playing the point. He's guarded now by Micah Paulson. Gives it over to Marquise Dre, who gives a nice screen for Michael. Outside for Steven. He shoots a three-pointer. It's up, and it's good. Early three-pointer, Steven Soak-Up. Tigers take a three-point lead. The point guard right now for Principia is Micah Paulson. He gets it over to Ross. Up top for Ball. He's being guarded by Marquise Jones. That's the matchup to watch tonight. The two big fellas battling it out on the inside. Principia working it around the arch. Paulson going inside for Ball. He's going to shoot a mid-range. Bounces. No, he's actually going to airball it. Rebounded by Steven Soak-Up. Brock Butler bringing it up. Going outside for Michael Soak-Up. Working it around the top of the arch. A screen set for Michael. He's working at the around mid-court. Goes inside for Marquise. He goes outside again. Another three-pointer. It's up. No good. A missed shot there for Michael Soak-Up. Rebounded by the Panthers. And here they come in fast transition. Paulson drives in. He has a lane. He's going to lay it up and in. Brock Butler, too slow to keep up with him, gets the two easy points, and now it's 3-2. Butler gets it up to Michael Soak-Up. Give it to Steven. He's in transition. He's going to be blocked by Ball. And then another block coming, and a call will be going against Principia. Or no, it's going to be going against the Tigers. It will be against Michael Soak-Up, his first of the game. So we said that Justin Ball was going to make an impact on tonight's game. And he already has a block. And making a defensive presence known for Principia. 3-2 Tigers lead. Ross to Ball. The big fella way up top at the top of the key. Over to Paulson. Guarded tightly by Brock Butler. Outside now for Ross. They keep moving around. It's in the hands of Amunu. He's mid-range, almost lost the ball there, but he gets it out to Paulson, who's driving again. He lays it up, no good, and it's going to be tipped out, and it will be rebounded by Ball and baseline to Parker Davidson, and he'll score on a nice pass. So now it's a 4-3 Panther lead. Principia is going for a full-court press kind of a trap here. Tigers are able to work with it. They get it across in time, and now they have about 19 seconds on the shot clock to work with. Michael Sokup over to his twin brother, Steven, who's trapped in the corner. Back to Michael. Inside for Marquise. He's backing out. Spin move. He's going to lay it up. Rattles around. No good. Marquise has gotten very deadly with that spin move, but it's no good. Panthers, they're slowing things down. They are a defensive-minded team. They score less points per game than they defend. So that's quite the stat to have. Outside, going inside now with ball. And again to Amunu, and he's going to be no good. Rebounded by Michael Sokup. He had to get very physical with that one because Justin Ball was coming in hot for the rebound. Jones gets it off to Michael, who gets it to Steven. Now to Mitch Dre. He's backing down. He's going to show the turnaround jumper, and he's going to be blocked by Jeff Ross. We said the physical style of this defensive squad for Principia is going to be a lot for the Tigers. You have Jeff Ross, who's 6'6", and Justin Ball, who's 6'8". And both are pretty big guys compared to the Tigers starting five.
They're either shorter than their advertised height, or the Westland's shorter, or they're taller, one of the two.
Michael Sokup around to Brock Butler. Tigers moving around. They go inside for Marquise. He goes outside. Three-pointer. It's deep for Steven Sokup. No good. And it's almost rebounded by Mitch Dre, but instead it's taken in by Parker Davidson. Panthers have it with Paulson. He's getting the call from head coach Todd Zimmerman. He goes over for Ross to Ball. I don't think he's got the range from three-point lane, so Marquise Jones is getting in plenty of space. Panthers moving around. They're trying to go inside for Ball. Marquise doing a good job of denying. Ball gets it. They're going to be battling down. He's going to shoot a mid-range. Bounces around. No good. Rebounded by Butler. And Ball's probably not used to trying to back down a big 300-pound man like Marquise Jones. Mitch Dre has it for Wesleyan. He's on the outside. He goes mid-range. He gets it off for Brock Butler. Arguably the most dangerous three-point shooter for the Tigers. He kicks it outside for Mitch Dre. No good. And the shot will go out of bounds. So Panther basketball. Principia leads 4-3. We have just under 16 minutes left to play here in the first half. Inbounding the ball will be Parker Davidson. He gives it off to Paulson. He's bringing the ball up and dictating the moves for the Panthers. He gets it right back after a pass. He's going to take a three-pointer. No good. Rebounded this time, but they're going to call a foul that time against Michael Sokup. They said he got too physical with Adaku Anamu. That's a name you don't always see. Anamu out of Laredo, Texas. That's Michael Sokup's second foul of the game. He'll check out. Coming in, C.J. Singletary, the sophomore out of Evanston, Illinois. Panthers inbound it. They get it to Anamu, who shoots a three-pointer, and he's going to hit. So the Panthers have a losing record on the season, but you can't tell by the way they're playing so far today. Singletary to Butler. Up for a dangerous pass to Steven Sokup. No foul called, though. Ball got quite physical with him. Butler over to Dre. He gives it off to Steven Sokup. Back to Butler. The zone defense for the Panthers is being very effective. Three-pointer. It's coming from Mitch Dre. It's no good. He shorted it just a tad. So rebounds coming out. Panthers lead 7-3. Paulson going to his left. He's picked up now by Marquise Dre. He's going to hit a step-back jumper right in his face. So a quick start for the Panthers leads to a timeout from Coach Huseman. They've gone on a 9-point run. It's 9-3 Principia lead. We'll take a quick timeout with them. We'll be right back after these messages.
Lockridge Land and Equipment is paying top dollar for all scrap metal for both ferrous and non-ferrous metals. They have certified scales, offer roll-off tub services, and a check cashing service. Call them today at 696-2503. Lockridge Land and Equipment. Open Monday through Friday from 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. and Saturdays from 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. at 2140 Velch Boulevard in Lockridge.
Little Mexico Restaurant serves up big flavor with their delicious, authentic Mexican cuisine. Start off with Little Mexico's famous chips and salsa, then explore a menu full of flavorful entrees. From classic dishes to unique specialties to the daily specials, there's something for everyone to enjoy. Located on the west side of the Mount Pleasant Square, stop by and enjoy the flavor of Little Mexico Restaurant.
Proudly serving Mount
Pleasant, and the surrounding areas. Steve Enberg, your shelter insurance agent, will find you the right policy, the right coverage at the right price, all while providing the quality service that you expect. They offer auto, home, life, renters, business, farm insurance, and a whole lot more. Call Steve today at 385-4519.
Welcome back, folks. We have a turnover by Elijah Johnson. It's still 9-3, but the Panthers will have the ball. Tigers are not off to their usual hot start, Ken, and like you said, they cannot get into a three-point shooting contest, because that's not how you win basketball games. And now we'll have a traveling call going against number 5, Trey Goodman. He's a freshman for the Panthers out of Plantation, Florida. So now a turnover for the Panthers leads to Tiger ball. They're not falling for this half-court trap. They've played it very well so far. No turnovers based off that. Butler has the ball. He gets it over to Elijah. And he has a pass taken away and stepping out of bounds. That was Adaku Amanu. That was a nice effort there, but he can't stay in bounds.
Battle of the cats tonight.
The big cats here.
The big cats.
And that was some cat-like reflexes there from Amanu. So now it's 9-3. Tigers trying to inbound. They do to Brock Butler. He's driving to his left. He's going to go right into the hole. He's going to try to lay it up. It's going to route around. No good. He gets the tip back. No good. He gets the rebound again. Puts it up, and that one finally goes. If at first you don't succeed, can't try and try again. And that's what Brock Butler just did.
Sure did, and that broke a 9-point run by the Panthers.
It's now 9-5, and we have a foul coming against Trey Goodman. We saw him turn the ball over earlier. Now he gets a foul ball on offense. I didn't see what happened. I think it might be a
blocking foul.
Yeah, blocking foul or illegal screen.
And he was moving.
Checking back in is Jeff Ross. So 9-5, Tigers get the ball back, and the Panthers have abandoned the full court press trap. They get into the corner of Singletary. He's driving in. He's right under the basket. He's going to put up a wild layup. I think he was looking for a foul call. Not enough contact, though, so it's coming back with the Panthers. Ross in transition to Paulson, who almost loses the handle. Going into the corner for Ross. He's wide open. He has Marquise Jones picking him up, but Marquise, not really a great perimeter defender. Now to ball. Unsure why he would pass off. He's being picked up there by Steven Sokup. He had a huge size advantage, but he goes out for Paulson. They're going cross court. Ball in the corner. He gets it off for Parker Davidson. He shoots a three. No good. Rebounded by Marquise Jones. Marquise dribbling. He's going to trip him up. Marquise going for a layup. Marquise scores! Of all my days here at Iowa Wesleyan, Ken, I've never seen Marquise Jones cross over somebody that dirty. He put Justin Ball on roller skates, put the big man on the floor, and then scores a beautiful layup with contact, and he's going to the line shooting one.
I was writing. I didn't say it.
That was play of the year, Kent.
I'm going to have to watch the video tape.
Marquise Jones coming in at 6'4", weighs around 300 pounds. Going against the other big fella in transition. You don't think he's going to play the point. Had a beautiful crossover, and again, put him on roller skates, put him on the ground, and then he scores on a contact play and makes the free throw. It's now 9-8. Marquise is going to get a well-deserved timeout, and checking in is Austin Walker out of Ottumwa right up the road, former Bulldog. Tigers starting to fight back. They're on a 5-point roll. They get inside for Justin Ball. They're going outside for Paulson. He's going to go mid-range. He's going to lose the ball, taken away. Austin Walker with the steal. Butler in transition over to Walker. Thought about shooting a three. Wisely pulled up. They go over to Johnson. To Butler. He's backing down Paulson. He's dribbling. He's going to go mid-range jumper. It's up. No good. The confidence of that beautiful crossover by Marquise has re-energized the Tiger offense.
There's no way you can defend a crossover.
No, dribble. You can't.
Superman couldn't even defend it.
Up top, Jeff Ross. They're going under the basket. That's going to be a turnover. And now we're starting to see the offensive struggles for Principia. Really struggling to move the ball around. They go inside there, but unable to get it in. They average about 10 assists per game. This is a team that, on average, scores 69.5 points per game. And they were off to a hot start, but right now they're being slowed down. Steven Sokup gets it past half court over to C.J. Singletary. He's going right to the hole. He's laying it up. Beautiful move, C.J. Singletary. Tigers take the lead back. They originally had a 3-0 lead, and then it was 9-3, and now the Tigers lead 10-9. And we just hit the 12-minute mark. Up top for Justin Ball. He's moving around to Paulson. Underneath to Davidson, who's trapped in the corner. He's going to kick it back out. Principia trying to reset and get a new play in motion. And they're going to take a three-pointer. It's up. No good. That was a very poor shot that time from Adaku. And here come the Tigers. Rebounded by C.J. Singletary. He's driving to the basket. A lot of contact. He finally gets the call. And that's the strength of C.J.'s game. He can drive. And he looks for that contact because he wants to shoot some free throws. He'll shoot two. Was unable to catch who the penalty was called on. Yeah, the officials do the two-handed call here. Kent and I are both the fans of the high school game where they only used one hand. Here comes first one. That's good for CJ. It's now 11-9. It's his third point. Checking in for the Tigers, Mitch Dre. He subbed in for Brock Butler. So you're five on the court. Steven Sokup, Austin Walker, Elijah Johnson, CJ Singletary, and Mitch Dre. Usually you don't see all five of these players all on the court at once. Misses the second, so it's a two-point game, 11-9. A little over 11 minutes left to play in the first half. Ross picked up by Walker on the outside, over to Paulson. He's guarded by Elijah Johnson. He's going to kick it over. Outside, Paulson, three-pointer, no good. Rebounded by Austin Walker. They're getting physical on these rebounds. It's refreshing to see. In transition, it's Mitch Dre wide open. The assist going to Steven Sokup. 13-9. In transition, they just lost complete control of the tallest starter for the Tigers. And I think we're going to have another turnover for Principia. Oh, they're going to say timeout, not a turnover. We'll take a timeout with them. 10 minutes and 52 seconds left to play in the first half. 13-9, Tigers lead. We'll be right back.
Avoid the hassle of travel and fly from Burlington. No waiting, no long lines, just easy travel. Serving Southeast Iowa, West Central Illinois, and Northeast Missouri, they partner with Air Choice One to get you to your destination without all of the headache. The next time you plan a trip, fly from the Southeast Iowa Regional Airport, your home field advantage.
Josh and Amber Jacobsmeyer invite you into their store on the east side of the Mount Pleasant Square to see the products they have to offer for your home or business. Carpet tile, ceramic, vinyl plank, vinyl tile, hardwood, and laminate. Need new carpet? Stop in and check out the selection of stock carpet at great prices. Jacobsmeyer Floors of Mount Pleasant. Check out their Facebook page for special pricing.
On the track, on the field, or on the court, Brown Shoe Fit has the shoes you need. They carry a wide array of styles, sizes, fits, and brands to make sure that you have the perfect shoe for you. Sports fans, they've got lots of fun and fashionable shoes. Come check them out at Brown Shoe Fit, where they've got a fit for every foot, on the east side of the Mount Pleasant Square.
Welcome back. Kaylor Went, Kent Bennett up top on the track in the Howe Activity Center. Tigers lead 13-9. The Panthers have the ball. Over to Paulson. Thought about shooting. He's picked up on the zone defense. He was over for Goodwin. Back to Paulson, who almost took a deep three, but he wisely held up. He's going to go inside, and he will be fouled. No, they're going to say he traveled. I thought they might have called a foul against Mitch Dre, but instead another Principia turnover.
Five turnovers for Principia, and Wesleyan's been able to turn that into 7 points.
And one of those turnover points was by Marquise Jones, who had play of the year for the Tigers when he got the ball and he tripped up a huge 6'8", 250 center in Justin Ball. Tigers have it. Steven Sokup over to Johnson. They're guarded one-on-one now. It looks like Principia's moved to a man defense. Austin Walker inside for Dre. Outside for Michael Sokup. He's going to drive in. Back outside for Dre. Three-pointer. That's going to be good. Mitch Dre hits a three-pointer. It's now 16-9. And when Dre gets hot, he gets very hot. He's kind of a streaky shooter, though. When he's cold, he's ice cold. And we have a three-pointer made immediately by Micah Paulson. And he brings it back to a four-point game, 16-12. And that's 8 points for Micah Paulson. He's pretty much the entire offense for Principia. Tigers almost have a ball stolen away. Mitch Dre going inside. He wants to shoot. No, he's going to pull out. Sokups Going to drive it in to C.J. Singletary, who put up an ugly-looking shot. Not sure what C.J. was thinking on that one. And here comes Principia. Paulson getting guarded up top by Johnson, outside for Goodwin. Tigers are in a zone defense, and they go inside for Adaku. And they're going to work it back out. They've had some trouble scoring the ball recently. Paulson kicks a deep three, no good. Rebounded by C.J. Singletary. Tigers are just attacking the hoop. C.J. Singletary wide open, will be blocked by Jeff Ross. And now the Panthers have a wide open layup in. Or no, it's going to be a jam by Adaku. It's now 16-14. So right when the Tigers were getting all the momentum in the game, here come the Panthers again. We have just hit the 9-minute mark. Make sure to stay tuned for the halftime show. Kent will give over the scores, or the score and the stats from the first half. And John Kuhns will be hopping on. He'll be talking to Coach Mark Rickman, the Tigers football coach. And we have a block by the Panthers. They're finding their footing again on defense. And here comes a three-pointer. That's good for Parker Davidson. Panthers take the lead back 17-6. That was a nice shot by the former Rebel. Steven Sokup knows that all the momentum is with Principia right now. Tigers have to take it back. C.J. Singletary trapped in the corner. Gets it over for Mitchell Dre to Johnson. Over to Steven. He takes the three-pointer. That's good. Now, Kemp, you said it before. Don't get in a three-point shooting contest, but it looks like the bell is rung, and they're going back and forth.
Both teams are shooting the three.
They're just trying to make it rain right now. 19-17, Tigers lead. A high pass almost out of bounds, saved by Davidson. And Principia was struggling to move the ball. They seem to have fixed that problem. Paulson will be fouled by C.J. Singletary. He got him on a pump fake and then went inside and kind of got a hip check. And checking back in for the Tigers, Michael Sokup, Marquise Jones, and Brock Butler coming in for Steven Sokup, Austin Walker, and Elijah Johnson. So you're five on the floor, Brock Butler, Michael Sokup, C.J. Singletary, Marquise Jones, and Mitch Dre. Tigers lead 19-17 with 7 and about a half minute left to play in the first half. Paulson. Davidson up top. Paulson gets again. He pump fakes. He's going right under the basket. Outside for Davidson. Three-pointer. It's up. No good. Rebounded by C.J. Singletary. He fights off Goodwin for it. I think Goodwin wanted a call. He's not going to get it. They give it to Marquise. Outside. Three-pointer. Mitch Dre. Yep. No good. That's a high rebound. And it'll be taken in by Parker Davidson. And the Panthers coming back in transition. Outside for Paulson. He wants to go right inside. Outside again for Davidson. They're passing it around. Goodwin's going to drive in. He's going to get an offensive charge call. Now, he had to have a lot of speed. That's his second foul of the game. But he had to have tremendous speed because he knocked over Marquise Jones. Marquise weighs around 300 pounds. He's built like an offensive lineman. So credit.
A little acting job on that. 150-pounder doesn't knock over a 350-pounder.
I don't know. He was like a speeding bullet, Kent. I mean, he was a bulldozer. 19-17. Tigers get it past half court. Michael Sokup over to Butler. Back to Sokup. And he gets it over to Jordan Nett, who just checked into the game. Inside for Mitch Dre, who's picked up by Ball and Ross on a double team. He's going to have to get rid of it. The two big fellas on him. Nett to Butler. He's going to dribble around. They're going outside. Sokup with the three. No good. Rebounded by Ball. You're not going to out-rebound Justin Ball. He's 6'8", 250. But you can trip him up, as we've seen. Adaku will be going in and laying it up. Let's see if they say the foul was before the act of shooting. No, they're going to say it was in the act of shooting. So he made the free throw, or he made the basket. So it's going to be one free throw. We're tied 19-19 with 6.5 minutes left to play. Adaku Anumu. I've been kind of butchering his name all night. It's an unusual one, and he hits his first one. It's now 20-19, Panthers lead. Butler over to Nutt. He's driving in. He gets it back to Butler. Over to Michael Sokup. He goes inside for Marquise. He's spinning around. He goes outside. Three-pointer. It's up for Brock Butler. No good. Oh, a nice rebound attempt there for Jordan Nutt. He can't hold on. Panthers in transition. Ross out to Davidson, over to Paulson, who's right on the half-court logo. He's going to slow things down. He's trying to call some plays over. Looking across court to Davidson, back to Paulson. Davidson shoots a three. That's good. So the former Tascosa Rebel standout hits another three-pointer. That's his eighth of the ball game. And it's now 23-19 Panther lead. The Tigers go inside with Nutt. He's going to throw up a wild-looking shot, and he gets no call on it, and he went for the rebound, got knocked over. So it comes back with the Panthers. Paulson on the outside. Now to Davidson, back to Paulson. They're doing a game of back and forth right now between Micah Paulson and Parker Davidson. Outside, Paulson getting it right back, inside out. He's going for Jeff Ross, who shoots it, hits another three-pointer. And then when it rains, it pours for the Panthers, apparently, because it's 26-19. They've really found their shot from beyond the arch. 5 minutes left in the half. Tigers down by seven. Butler has to get it past half court. He does over to Dre. Dre working on Jeff Ross. He puts it over to Michael Sokup. Over to Butler at the top of the key. Back to Sokup. He's going to drive in. He's going for Marquise Jones, who shoots a mid-range. He gets it to go. Marquise Jones having quite the game tonight. 26-20 now, or 21 now the score. Looking to check in is Steven Sokup. And Paulson over to Davidson. He's going right inside, and he throws a pass right into the open legs of Justin Ball. That would have been two easy points, but instead it's a turnover. Checking in for Principia is number zero, James McFarland out of Leland, Michigan. He's checking in for Jeff Ross. And Steven Sokup checked in for Jordan Nutt. So you have the Sokup twins, Mitch Dre, Brock Butler, and Marquise Jones. And a dangerous pass for the Tigers, saved by Mitch Dre. Into the corner. Driving is Steven Sokup. Outside for Brock Butler. Three-pointer, and that's going to hit. 26-24. This game's had ups and downs. It's been a good game so far for both teams to start. Two-point ball game. Principia has the lead. The Panthers getting all of their points basically from beyond the arch. They really haven't gone inside for Ball a lot. Paulson is outside for McFarland. He's going to pass it right back. And he sets a screen for Paulson, who's going to drive. But we're going to have a call going against Adaku Anumu. I think they were going to say blocking foul.
That's the third offensive foul for the Panthers. All three of them on illegal screens.
Offense really isn't their strong suit. It's more, like we said, they're a defensive team. They allow around 76 points a game, but they only score 70 points a game. You're not going to win a lot of games that way, Kent.
No, you're sure not.
You typically have to score more than the opposing team to win.
That's the way it generally works.
Michael Soka picked up on a double team. He gets it off for Butler. Over to the corner for Steven. Wide open three-pointer. No good. Rebounded by Marquise Jones, and he gets fouled by Adaku. So Marquise, who's really become a veteran leader for the Tigers, is now giving advice, some stern advice, to the rest of his teammates about, I think, where they need to be spaced out on the floor. 3.5 minutes left to play in the first half. Tigers now trail by one as Marquise hits the first free throw. 26-25. Coming in, TJ Singletary checking out Mike Sokup. So Marquise can tie this ball game up if he converts this free throw. Again, during the halftime show, make sure to stay tuned in. John Kuehn's talking with Tigers football head coach Mark Rickman. Or Mike Rickman, excuse me. It's all tied up, 26-26. Panthers have the ball. Goodman covered by Singletary, outside for Ball. Really haven't seen Justin Ball be too involved here for the Panthers in this game. Good job by Marquise Jones to deny any interior passes. Paulson backs down on Brock Butler and gets it to fall. And Michael Paulson has been easily the best player tonight for the Panthers on both sides of the court. Almost a loose ball there for Marquise Jones. He wrangles it in, gets it over for Brock Butler. Back to Marquise. He gets it over for Brock. He had an opportunity to shoot a three. He holds up. He goes up top for Dre. Guarded by Goodwin. He's dribbling in. He goes outside. Tigers going around the arch. Inside Marquise. Outside for Jones. Or for Butler. Butler shoots a three. He gets it to go. Brock Butler is starting to catch fire from the outskirts, and now it's 29-28. Tigers regain the lead. 2.5 minutes left to play in the first half. Paulson to Davidson. He's at the top of the key. He gets it off for McFarland. And the zone coverage is back for the Tigers. Well, now it's a bit more of a man. Into the corner with McFarland. They're going for ball, and it's going to be denied by Marquise. And they had the size advantage going into this game, but I don't think we've seen Justin Ball get an interior pass yet.
Well, he's setting himself up too high.
He did.
He's got to get on the low block where he can do something once he gets the ball.
And
he's setting up about 10 feet away, and he's not going to hit that 10-foot shot.
And Marquise Jones has had quite the effort tonight, and now the officials are kind of talking to Marquise. And they're telling him maybe to settle down on defense a little bit. He's getting pretty physical. Outside, they give it to Jeff Ross on the inbound. Back to Paulson. Outside for Davidson. He shoots a long three. No good. Rebounded by Singletary. Over to Brock Butler. He gives it off to CJ. He's dribbling in on Ball. He goes right to the free throw line to Marquise. Marquise backing down. He's using his big frame to go outside now for Butler. Another three-pointer. Make that three threes in a row for Brock Butler, and it's now 32-28 with a minute 47 left to play in the first half. We have a timeout. Let's take one with them. We'll be right back after these messages.
All right, able to get down 35, it'll be 37, I am at a bit 36. Folks, this is Jim Huff for Sullivan Auctioneers. If you have an auction in your future, let us give your auction the local attention as well as the national exposure that it deserves. Call Jim Huff at 319-931-9292. Or check us out at SullivanAuctioneers.com.
Midwest Precast Concrete has helped to grow our region. You'll see their name on projects all around the area, and that's because they're the best around. MPC is a precast company that manufactures architectural and structural precast concrete for projects such as schools, hospitals, and office buildings all around the state and beyond. Visit their website at mpcent.com.
Jason Smith Plumbing, Heating, and Cooling are industry leaders in Southeast Iowa. They handle residential and commercial services and will fix any issues that may arise. Jason and his staff are trained professionals that will have your current system running at its very best or will find a system perfect for your needs. Contact Jason Smith Plumbing, Heating, and Cooling today at 986-6957.
Welcome back, folks. We're here with about a minute 47 left to play in the first half. Tigers have just taken the lead, 32-28, off another three-pointer. And Kent, you said during the break, this is a streaky shooting game. We've seen times when both teams are shooting very well and then some very low times where they're not shooting anything well.
Yeah, that's very true. And usually when you go on a run, it's 6 points. Those are very common. And that's what it's been tonight.
A three-pointer there from Paulson. No good. Rebounded by C.J. Singletary. And Brock Butler bringing it up for Iowa Wesleyan. Marquise has it. He gives it off to soak up over to Dre. Back to Butler on the right side. Guarded by Paulson. He goes inside for Steven Sokup, who's backing down. He spins. He's trying to go inside. He gets the contact. That's going against Jeff Ross. And not the famous comedian Jeff Ross, but the basketball player from Principia, Jeff Ross. So Steven Sokup going to the free throw line to shoot some free throws. And during the break, I had to text some of my contacts at Tascosa High School, and they gave me a scouting report so far on Parker Davidson for Principia. They said he's a good shooter, and I think we've seen that so far tonight. He's hit some good three-pointers.
Yeah, he sure has.
He hits the first one, and the second free throw falls for Steven Sokup. It's now 34-28. Just a few seconds, over a minute left to play in this first half. During halftime, we'll have Kent's giving you an update and breakdown of the stats. And we have a ball thrown away by Justin Ball, able to be saved by Micah Paulson. Paulson has clearly been the engine behind Principia tonight. Also during halftime, head coach Mike Rickman of the Tiger football team will be talking with John Kuehns. We have a foul call going against the Tigers. Micah Paulson came in and then kicked it out, but they will be calling it against Mitch Dre. He got too physical. Maybe he was reaching in a little too much, going for the steal. So Paulson, the inbounder. He gets it outside for Ball, who's guarded by Brock Butler. What a big change in height between those two. outside for Adaku. He's guarded by Dre. He's going to hold up mid-range. He gets it to fall. 34-30. 30 seconds left to play in the first half. Tigers just trying to get it past half court. They still have yet to fall victim to this full court trap. Dre over to Butler. Outside for Marquise. And he's looking for some help. He gives it over for CJ, who drives in. He's going to go right for the hole. CJ lays it up, rattles around, and it gets to go. Nice move, CJ Singletary. Last season, we really didn't see him attack the basket very much. And he's really stepped up this game this year. Getting to the basket, getting contact, still making some tough shots. And now the Panthers are unable to get a shot off. And ball's going to get it up, but not in time. A double team on Paulson was clutch.
We'll have you calling them for all of your glass needs.
Bring it all back.
This is located on the north edge of Mount Pleasant and can be reached at 385-8804.
Welcome back. Perfect timing. We're coming back right as the buzzer goes off, and the Tigers and Panthers are getting ready for round number two in this heavyweight battle. 36-30, Tigers lead. It was a streaky first half, and we'll see if they can get more consistency here in the second half. Paulson trying to go inside. He's going to go outside for Jeff Ross. Inside for Ball, who's going to shoot a three, or not almost a three, he's just short a little bit. It was a mid-range that he missed, and here come the Tigers. Michael Sokup gets it over to Steven. Now Michael's going to drive in. He's going under the basket right to Marquise. He's going to back down, going up. He's going to fight for the rebound and gets it right back. Going outside, nice decision by Marquise. He is just having a great night tonight, making wise decisions all over the court. He's going to kick it over to Dre, to Butler. They have 19 seconds to make something work. Butler's going to have a short-range jumper. That one's going to fall. He crossed up his defender and Paulson. Well, we've seen that before tonight. It's now 38-30. Panthers have it right back. Paulson's going to drive right in on Butler. He's going to try to go up. He's going to spin. He's going to go right to the mid-range with Ball, who kicks it out. Ross has it in the corner, going inside for Ball. He was very ineffective that first half, and now he gets a post score on Marquise Jones.
That's his first points of the night.
His first points of the night. That's kind of very strange to say from a 6'8 guy who weighs 250. He's a dominating force. Three-pointer. Steven Sokup, no good. And the rebound will be out of bounds against Mitch Dre. Dre trying to convince him that it was last touched by Ball. And the main reason I think that we didn't see a lot of Ball was he was just getting smothered by Marquise Jones in the post. And he wasn't setting himself up right to get the easy passes and buckets. Paulson gives it over to Parker Davidson. Back to Paulson. Shoots a three-pointer. It's up. No good. Rebounded by Adaku. It'll be out of bounds. Last touched that time by Michael Sokup, so he'll stay with the Panthers. I got another note here for Parker Davidson. He also plays baseball at Principia. That was the main draw for him to the Panthers. Inbound. He gets the ball over to Ross. He gets it to Paulson. He's guarded by Steven Sokup. He goes over to Davidson. Now inside for Adaku, who shoots a three-pointer. And that one's going to fall. That was not the prettiest of shots. He gets it to fall, so who's the one to judge? 38-35 now the score. Here comes the half-court pass, and the going to be taken away by Paulson. And that's going to be an alley-oop, but it's going to be deflected by Mitch Dre. That was a great defensive effort by Dre after the turnover. That's the first turnover the Panthers have got from the full-court trap. Tigers fell right into it.
I think that's only their second turnover the entire game.
They've been very good. I actually have the stats right here. For the Tigers, that's actually their third of the game. So they have been very efficient with the basketball. Paulson going around. Panthers trail by three. Adaku thought about shooting for Zane. He's going inside. Ball backing down. He wants to shoot on Marquise, and he will be fouled by Marquise. And Ball's finally getting into the game more, and that could be a big turning point for the Panthers. They can get a big interior presence. Marquise is going to have to play very wisely because he's out-righted here. And then in transition, a pass right to Brock Butler, and he's going to lay it in. He did the Willie Mays catch. Marquise Jones got the steal and threw it way above down court for Brock Butler, and Butler ran under it like a wide receiver going deep, and Willie Mays catched it right over his shoulders for an easy bucket, 40-35. If there's a player of the game so far, it's got to be Marquise Jones. And Ball shoots. He's going to be no good. Nice defense there by Marquise. In transition. He gets it to Dre. He goes back to Jones. Underneath the basket. And then laying it in is going to be Michael Sokup. So both teams making a big effort to score from the inside and not rely on the three-pointer as much. 42-35. The Tigers still have the lead. Davidson gets a screen. He's being guarded by Steven Sokup. He goes to Adaku, who's picked up by Michael Sokup. He chips him up, and there's a beautiful crossover. He misses the three, though, and now we have a foul call against Parker Davidson. Or that one might be actually against one of the Sokup twins. I think they're going to say that one against Steven Sokup. That's his first foul of the game. He was also the one, I think, that got tripped up on the crossover. That one was not nearly as good as Marquise Jones's on Justin Ball
There's
earlier.
There's just no way you can defend the crossover dribble.
They're going outside for Ball. He's trapped in the corner. He's trying to go inside for Adaku, who shoots. No good. Rebounded. It's going to be fought for. Won by Brock Butler. He's in transition. He's going to slow things down. Wants the rest of his teammates to catch up. He goes over to Marquise, who tries the dribble again. He's going in. He's going to be fouled by Ball. And Justin Ball, for a second, we thought he was going to try to turn his half around, and that's so far not the case. Coach Huseman talking to his four smaller players while Marquise goes to the line and shoots a pair of free throws. Let's look at how Jones played in that first half as he gets ready to shoot. His first one's up and good. Marquise was 2 of 3 from the floor, and he made all three of his free throws. He had 2 rebounds, 7 total points. He had 2 assists. And, of course, that one crossover that won't get to go into the stat line. And he hits his second. Marquise playing lights out from the line, and it's 44-35, Tigers lead. Paulson over to Goodwin. He's picked up by Dre. He's going to dribble. He's going inside. He's going to be fouled, and he makes the bucket. And now Mitch Dre's starting to struggle a bit. And C.J. Singletary is going to be checking in for Dre. So now it's 44-37. And here comes CJ. Let's see if I'm correct in my prediction. Yep, he's coming in for Mitch Dre. This is turning into a defensive battle, so I think Coach Huseman wants a more defensive-minded player in right now. Goodwin shoots and makes it, so it's now 44-38. The inbound, here comes the full court trap again. They get it to Marquise. He's going over for CJ. CJ, he's going to be going inside. He's going to do a floater in the lane. It's going to rattle around. No good. It's rebounded by Ball. Now he gets it over for Paulson, who's picked up on his own trap. He gets it out to Adaku inside for Ball, and he's going to lay it up in transition right in the face of Michael Sokup. Sokup wisely got out of the way because that's a big man coming down the tracks. Tigers get it across half court with Marquise Jones. He needs some help, though. He gets it out to Butler. Butler needs help now. And the ball's going to be taken away, and it's on the ground. I think they might be calling a foul against Adaku. I think that's going to be a reach-in foul. Yep, it's going to be going against Adaku Anumu. That might be the best name we've got to call so far this year. Inbound will be coming into Marquise. We have 15 and a half minutes left in the ball game to play. They're going inbounds, and that's going to be C.J. Singletary. He's blocked by Parker Davidson, but they're going to call Davidson for the foul. So C.J. will go to the line, shooting 2. Let's look at the stats in the first half for C.J. He was 2 of 6 from the floor, 1 of 2 on his free throws. He had 5 total points, and he also had 5 rebounds, which was the leading rebounder for the Tigers. Let's see how he can doing his 2 free throws here. Tigers only up 44-40. And he hits his first one. And this should be a game where they outscore Principia by quite a bit because they average 20 more points a game than the Panthers do. But so far that has not been the case. Free throws up. Rattles around. It's good. Now it's 46-40. But if we've learned anything from this game, that it's a streaky night, and any team can catch fire at will. Davidson will go in. He will be fouled that time by Steven Sokup. I don't know about that one. It looked like he created all the contact. I think that's what Coach Huseman was trying to say to the officials. Inbound by Paulson. He's going under to Adaku, who gets a nice easy layup. C.J. Singletary was caught sleeping. And now C.J.'s going to be bringing it up. They have to get it past half court. He does to Michael Sokup. Goes cross court to Butler. Into the corner for Steven Sokup. Three-pointer. It's up. That's going to be good. Steven Sokup hits a three-pointer. It's now a seven-point ball game, 49-42. 11 points for Steven so far tonight. Paulson outside for Goodman. Panthers working around. We have a foul call. This one against Marquise Jones. Jones getting too physical with Justin Ball. That's not a bad foul to do. You got to let Ball know that he's going to be physical. You're going to be physical right back. And he's actually going to check out, and coming in is Jeff Ross. So a smaller lineup here for the Panthers, but arguably a better offensive lineup for him. And now we have a timeout taken on the court. We'll take one with him. 14:54 left to play here in the game. Tigers lead 49-42. We'll be right back here on IWTigers.com and KILJ Radio.
Two locations, great service. Mike's Automotive of Salem and K&M Auto New London have your car needs covered. They have years of experience. With that comes the knowledge needed to diagnose and treat your car problems and to find issues before they become big problems. Your car is a huge investment, so trust only the best, and it will keep running for years to come. K&M Auto and Mike's Automotive.
Lose it with the Rec Center. The two-person weight loss challenge starts January 9th. Prizes will be given to the first three teams with the largest percent loss. And top prize includes $500 cash. Cost to enter is $15 per person for members, $30 per person for non-members. Registration goes through January 8th. Contact the Rec Center to get registered.
When the summer heat is sweltering or the winter's cold is freezing, you want to make sure that your home can handle it all. That's where C&M Heating, Cooling, and Plumbing comes in. Their staff has professionals with the expertise to ensure that your current system is running at its full ability and can fix any problems or issues you may have. Call C&M Heating, Cooling, and Plumbing today, 385-4125.
Welcome back. Taylor Wentz, Kent Bennett on the call here on 105.5 FM, KILJ, online at KILJ.com, and another online source at IWTigers.com, or else a video feed. Right now, the Tigers lead 49-42. We almost have a steal, that one, by Michael Sokup. The officials trying to make a call here, but they're not going to say Tiger basketball. It looked like it was out on Trey Goodman. They're going to say it was actually out on Sokup. So it's still Panther ball. Paulson going right into the hole. He's going to lay it up. And he is flown past some defenders today. He goes right to the hole. That's his 11th point of the ball game. Tigers not trying to fall into the full court trap. Johnson's caught now by Sokup. Outside for Steven. Back to CJ. He's going to spin in. And he goes right under the basket to Michael Sokup. Lays it up. No good. Rebounded by Jeff Ross. And now the Panthers have the ball back. They trail by five. A little over 14 minutes left to play in the ball game. Paulson trying to go right back in. He gets it to Davidson, who will be fouled. And now we have a confrontation between Steven Sokup and Parker Davidson. Davidson going to the line, shooting two. Let's look at the stats for Parker Davidson. He had a good half. He was 3-6 on the floor, 2-5 on his three-pointers. He did not have any free throws. He had 8 total points, 8 rebounds. He led all rebounders in the first half. That free throw is good. It's a 4-point ball game, 49-45.
You know, both teams are shooting extremely well. Wesleyan is 10 out of 11 from the line, and so far they're 4 out of 4.
He shoots his second. Rattles around, no good. Shorted it. Rebounded by C.J. Singletary.
Put the hex on him.
Here comes C.J. He gives it over to Michael Sokup, who's taken over the main point guard responsibilities this season. He gets a screen from Marquise. He goes right back into it. He's going to shoot a long mid-range jumper. No good. And rebounded by Principia. Davidson. Outside for Goodman. He's going to drive right in, and he gets under the basket, lays it up, and no good. Rebounded by himself, and he's going to get the contact call. So he'll shoot two, and The Sokups are starting to get in some foul trouble. We have a little over 13 and a half minutes left to play. That's his third foul of the ball game. And Goodman shooting two. If you're the Tigers, you can't let him have 3 points. And he misses his first free throw, and it's still a four-point ball game. Checking in, Brock Butler and Mitchell Dre coming in for Marquise Jones, and I think it was Michael Sokup. It was. So Steven's still out there. Goodman's going to attempt his second free throw. It seems that the Panthers have had a much better job of getting to the basket tonight, while the Tigers have shot a little bit better from the floor. Elijah Johnson almost caught on that full court press. CJ has it. He needs some help, and he's going to be taken away by Parker Davidson to Goodman in transition. He's going to lay it up and get it to go. And now it's a one-point ball game, 49-48. Like we said, it's been a streaky ball game, and right now the streak's in favor of the Panthers. They're going up. Oh, almost an alley-oop there for Mitch Dre. He's under the basket, a lot of contact. He finally doesn't get it to go, and he misses again on the follow-up. Mitch Dre having a terrible night right now. Panthers coming back, and they're looking for the lead. Adaku driving right to the basket, and he will be fouled. 49-48. And if you're Coach Huseman, you've got to call a timeout here and settle your team down a bit. 13:01 left in the ballgame. Tigers still hold on to the slimmest of leads. And Adaku shooting his first free throw. It's up, and it will be good. So we have a tie ball game at 49 points apiece. Here comes his second. It's up and it's good. So the Panthers take the lead back. It's now 50-49. The full court trap. Tigers have fallen victim to it here in the second half. They were pretty effective against it in that first half. Butler goes to Elijah, to CJ. He's going to drive right in. He's looking for some contact. He's going to get it. That foul will be going against Adaku. Or no, they're going to say it was Micah Paulson. That's his second foul of the game. And CJ, again, really improving his driving game this season, getting back to the free throw line. It's up, and he hits the first one, so we're tied up at 50 points. Here comes his second free throw. Rattles around. Oh, no good. That one was hanging on the rim, and it falls out. So we're tied at 50.
We've had 7 lead exchanges and 3 ties so far tonight.
This has been a great ball game for both teams. Goodman outside for Paulson. The main issue that seems to me is they can't stay in front of their Principia opponents when the Panthers have the ball. They're going to Adaku. Step back jumper. It's up, and that's going to be good. That's a 3-pointer. It's now 53-50, and it seems all the momentum is with the Panthers. Butler over to C.J. Singletary. He's going to try to stay out of the half-court press. He gets it over to Butler. Passes it over to Elijah on the left side. Now they have to face a zone defense. They go to Butler. Back to Johnson. Two pump fakes. He's going inside to Dre. Outside. For Steven Sokup. He's going to go mid-range. No, he goes outside for Butler. That's a deep three-pointer. No good. It's going to be rebounded by Dre. The ball's on the ground. Taken away by Goodman. Here come the Panthers. They're in fast break. And it's going to be Parker Davidson. He'll be fouled by Elijah Johnson. And if there's a theme to the second half, it's that the Panthers are getting to the line while the Tigers are unable to. And again, all the momentum right now is with Principia. It looks like Marquise Jones will be checking back in. And for the first time tonight, it's going to be Kalen Hernandez-Biner coming in for Principia. Rattles out his first free throw. So the most damage he can do is make it a 4-point ball game. Marquise checks in for C.J. Singletary. So your 5 Tigers on the floor. Elijah Johnson, Brock Butler, Mitch Dre, Steven Sokup and Marquise Jones. And now we see Michael Sokup checking in for Elijah Johnson, so scratch that five. Here comes the second free throw for Parker Davidson. It's up. No good. He misses them both. Brock Butler crossing half court. He's picked up now by Biner. They're going inside for Michael Sokup. He's guarded by Paulson. He's under the basket looking to lay it up, and he gets it to go. What a tough reverse layup. And that might be what they need to get the engine started here for the Tiger offense. They average about 90 points a game. Right now they're stuck at 52. Panthers still lead by one, 53-52. A little over 11 minutes left to play. Paulson gets right out of the basket. He's blocked by Brock Butler. Here come the Tigers. They're on a fast break. And Butler going right up into the lane. He gets it to go. Easy layup. And a timeout taken by Coach Huseman. It's now 54-53 Tigers lead. They take a timeout. Let's take one with them. We'll be right back with 11 minutes left to play right here on KILJ Radio and IWTigers.com.
Savings Bank, and as this holiday season brings another good year to its close, all of us here send our best wishes and thanks to our customer family and our community. We're proud to serve our neighbors here in Southeast Iowa and beyond, and as we count our many blessings at this special time of year, we wish you and your family a wonderful holiday season from our family at Pilot Grove Savings Bank. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Talking with Mike Anderson, Schottenkirk, Mount Pleasant. You know, Mike, price has made you guys number one in the state, or close to number one, especially with Chrysler. Service is what's kept you number one. How do you guys keep your customers around?
Well, we keep them there by taking care of them. That's the biggest thing. We go up to 100 miles away, even for an oil change, free of charge, and that's just taking care of people.
And then you have Schottenkirk Customer Care, and this is complimentary dent, wheel, tire, windshield repair. So you're going to get the best price, and you're going to get taken care of. That's why they're number one, Schottenkirk Automotive, Mount Pleasant.
Welcome back. The Panthers on offense right now. Give it over to Paulson. Back to Davidson in the corner for Biner. He almost had a turnover. He goes outside for Paulson, who's going to chip up his defender. He's going to shoot a three, and that one's going to rattle around. No good, and rebounded by Brock Butler. Butler gets it past half court. Over to Steven, who's going to drive in, and there's going to be a call going against Jeff Ross. He looked like he got all ball, but I think he also got a little too much arm on him. So going to the line, shooting two, Steven Sokup. And Kent, it seemed that first half it was all three-pointers. Now this half it seems it's all free throws.
Yeah, so far this will be a 7-8 shot this half for the Tigers.
That one no good. That's a rare miss for Steven Sokup. And checking in is the big man, Justin Ball. He's coming in for Kalen Hernandez-Biner. Here comes the second one for Steven. 1 point ball game. It's up and he hits it. So now a 2 point ball game. 55-53. 10.5 minutes left to play. Who's going to win this big boxing match almost? They've been throwing haymakers at each other all night. Someone has got to have to pull this one out. And that's going to be a turnover for the Panthers. They were going for Ball, overthrew him, taken away by Steven Sokup. Butler to Steven. He's going to go right into the paint. He's going to lay it up and he's going to be fouled by Ball. And one bucket coming for Steven Sokup. And these are the moments why Coach Huseman went after the Sokup twins. We saw these late games last season, and they're kind of squandered with the Tigers. And now we're having some great plays made by some great players. Another timeout taken. Let's take one with them. 10 minutes left to play. Tigers lead 57-53. We'll be right back.
We use our cell phones for a lot. They give us directions, answer questions, entertain us, and occasionally make calls. We do so much with our phones, so buy them from somebody who knows the product. Sound Advice has been in business for years and carry only the brands that they believe in. Get your phone at Sound Advice of Uptown Mount Pleasant, open at their extended location. Please enter through the old main entrance to the Brazelton Hotel.
Mount Pleasant Motors has of the best deals on used cars in Southeast Iowa. Their diverse selection of available cars offers plenty of choices for you to find the perfect fit. Mount Pleasant Motors is open Monday through Friday, 9 to 5, and they offer financing. Mount Pleasant Motors, 1207 East Washington Street, online at mountpleasantmotors.net.
MD Orthopedics of Wayland has been providing an effective, patient-friendly device to assist in the treatment of clubfoot. Founder John Mitchell and the dedicated staff hope that you'll enjoy this sports broadcast. With the help of MD Orthopedics and their cutting-edge technology and products, some children with physical issues today will be the star athletes of tomorrow.
Welcome back, folks. We're in a tight race here between the Principia Panthers and your Iowa Wesleyan Tigers. Tigers lead 57-53. The next game for Iowa Wesleyan will be this Saturday down in Louisville, Kentucky, as the Tigers will be playing Spalding, who is 1-5 overall in the season, 0-2. The Panthers will be having a tougher test this Saturday as they go play at Eureka, who is 6-1 and 1-1 in the conference. Steven Sokup hits his and-one shot. It's now 58-53. 10 minutes exactly left to play. Paulson guarded by Butler. And Paulson going to his right. They're going outside for Goodman. He's picked up by Dre. Spin move. He needs some help. He's going for Adaku. Who's going to drive in himself? He's going to go for a jumper. No good. Rebounded here by Steven Sokup. So the jump shots really aren't falling for the Panthers. They're getting those 3 points. And a reverse layup for Steven Sokup. That's the second one he's made tonight. We're seeing great basketball played right now by the Tigers. They were struggling a bit, and it seems they found some success. 7-point ball game, 60-53. Davidson into the corner for Adaku. He's a quick shot trigger finger, and he gets it to go that time. 60-56 after that three-pointer.
Just here's when you think you've got them, they fight their way back in it.
And right now they're going outside. Steven Sokup three-pointer. That one's going to fall. So the Panthers make one, and Steven Sokup says that was a good idea. I think I'll give it a try. And he hits a three-pointer. 63-56. 9 minutes to go, and here comes Mitch Dre on the fast break. He gets a steal, and he's going to be stripped, and they're going to say no foul against Trey Goodman. I think Dre was really upset with that call. He really got whacked on that one, but they're going to say it was all ball. So now with 8 minutes and 50 seconds left to play, Tigers will inbound. They're going to go inbound to Dre. He goes right under the basket, lays it up. He's going to be blocked from behind by ball. He gets the rebound back. He needs some help. Outside for Butler, three-pointer, it's good. Brock Butler has been on fire from behind the arch tonight. It's now a 10-point ball game, 66-56. I think that this is the largest lead of the night for the Tigers.
It is.
And a foul going against Justin Ball. He got too physical with Mitch Dre. And the big fellas, the big physical presence, but he's been a little bit uncoordinated tonight, and he's had some penalty calls and some turnovers, and a timeout called. Let's stay here, though. So, Kent, we have 8.5 minutes. The Tigers have all the momentum right now. They're up by 10. What do you do to build off the success they found here in the second half?
Well, their half-court trap has thrown Principia out of their offense, and they're more comfortable setting in right at the top of the key, and they're setting up their offense probably 7 or 8 feet from the half-court line, and they're just out of sync right now. And Justin Ball, I don't know what his average is for the season, but he's only scored 4 points tonight, the biggest player on the floor, and he's been very ineffective, and credit Marquise Jones for that. But all of a sudden, the offense has come alive, and especially for Steven Sokup, he's got 20 points right now, and he's playing excellent basketball.
And both teams coming back out. We have exactly 8 minutes and 29 seconds left to play. Tigers have gone on a run. They lead by 10. And Mitch Dre will be the inbounder. Brock Butler gets it. And the Panthers have abandoned their full court trap. Michael gives it to Jones. He's trying to back down the ball. He gets it over for Butler. He's mid-range. Jumper. It's up. And, it looked like it was in, but it rattles out. Parker Davidson now being caught up here by Parker or by Marquise Jones. He gets it off for Paulson, who gets it past half court. The zone defense is really making some struggling offense for the Panthers, but we have a three-pointer falling for Parker Davidson. It's now 66-59. If you're the Tigers, you don't want to get into another three-point contest. You just got to keep going inside, getting the nice, easy shots, and if there's a three, then you take it. Don't make it your whole game. And we have an inside move, and that was Michael Sokup. He's fouled. That one might be going against Ball again.
If it is, I think that's number five.
And they do call it on Ball, and he'll be coming out, and I believe Jeff Ross will be substituting for him.
Must be just four.
And here he comes. I know he's a little too eager to get out of the game. The officials having a give him the whistle. Michael Sokup shoots. It's up. No good. He put a little too much on that free throw. Hits the back of the rim and out. Jeff Ross does come in for Ball. So they're again going with a smaller lineup, which has been very effective for him at times. The officials have to stop real fast. I think they're going to discuss something. But here comes the second free throw.
Substitution was for Michael.
And here comes Michael Sokup out of the game. And C.J. Singletary will be taking his place on the court. Your five on the floor, Brock Butler, C.J. Singletary, Mitch Dre, Steven Sokup, and Marquise Jones. Paulson outside to Goodman. He goes back to Paulson. He's going to drive in off a screen outside for Ross. Thought about shooting a three. He's not going to take it. And they're going to give it to Goodman, who gets a nice high layup off the glass. Six-point ball game, 67-61. The Tigers really seem to take their foot off the gas. Butler getting a screen from Marquise. He gets it over to Dre in the corner. Inside, it's Steven Sokup, guarded by Davidson. He's going to back in. He's going to lay it up. No good. It's going to be fought for a rebound. It's going to be Marquise. He's going to put it up. No good. It's going to be tipped out. And it's going to be Panther Ball. And 7 minutes left. And there goes Jeff Ross. And that's a foul call against, I believe, is that Steven Sokup? No, that was Mitch Dre. Dre trying to make his case. He said, I had my feet planted. He ran into me, but it means to no avail. So an and-one shot. The Panthers charging back. We should have known anytime someone gets the upper hand, it's not for long.
No, it sure isn't. I think that's the other team's signal to come on back.
They just let the door wide open. Michael Sokup checking in for Mitch Dre. So not a very long rest there for Michael. But he's a competitor. He wants to get back in quickly. So now it's a four-point ball game. If Ross can hit this free throw, it's a three-point ball game. Tigers were shortly up by 10 points. It seemed just a minute ago.
It was 2 minutes ago.
2 minutes ago, that's what it was. Driving in, there's a steal against Michael Sokup. They're going to give it to Goodman in transition. He lays it up and in, and now it's a one-point ball game. The Tigers, I don't know if it's complacency or what is the problem, but they've given up a big run for the Panthers, and it's now 67-66, and Butler will lay it in. No good. Rebounded by Marquise. He gets fouled at the line. They're not going to call it, but he gets the rebound to go in. So now it's 69-66. Paulson on the outside. He's guarded by Butler. And Paulson's going to go right inside. Spins. Goes right under to Ross. He's going to lay it up. Thought he was going to dunk it for a second, but he's just going to get the nice, easy points. 69-68 our scores. 6 minutes left to play. Butler over to C.J. Singletary. He's getting a screen from Steven. He's not going to use it. He's going right in. He's going to get the easy bucket. No good. The Tigers have been unable to buy a bucket lately. And here comes Goodman. And he's going to lay it up. He's fouled by Brock Butler. And Butler is imploring to his teammates. He needs some defensive help there. So with 5 minutes and 53 seconds left in the ball game, Tre Goodman will be shooting 2 free throws. He can take the lead if he hits them both. Here comes his first. Up and good.
That's Goodman's 11th point of the second half.
He's been electrifying, and a timeout taken on the court. We're tied 69-69. Let's take a timeout with them. We'll be right back here on IW Tigers in or IWTigers.com and KILJ.com. We'll be right back.
Sunnybrook Assisted Living at Mount Pleasant. There are a wide range of apartment options to fit your needs. Choose from spacious studios or one bedrooms with a full bath and kitchenette and most utilities Costs are included. Apartments are maintenance-free inside and out. Call to take a tour. SunnybrookMTPleasant.com. Live your life better.
Your car does it all, so don't let a flat tire slow things down. At Mount Pleasant Tire, they offer top tire brands, including Goodyear, Dunlop, and Kelly Tires. Their certified technicians have the training and expertise to get your car up and running on sturdy, reliable tires. Mount Pleasant Tire, 1305 East Washington Street, 385-3022.
Teamwork is all about working together, following a plan and staying the course. This is true in both sports and for Lomond Industries of Mount Pleasant. They are the premier designer of products for the plastics industry, and that comes because of their focus on technology, their facilities, and their experienced staff. The team at Lomond Industries of Mount Pleasant wishes your team good luck.
Welcome back, folks. We're all tied up 69-69 with 5 minutes and 53 seconds left to play. Trey Goodman will be going back to the line to shoot one more free throw. And Kent, you were just saying it. Complacency a little bit for the Tigers. They're up by 10, 66-56, and now they're all tied up at 69, and they might lose the lead here.
Yeah, they've got a chance to go behind by a point, and with 8:05 remaining in the game, they were up by 10, 66-56, but it's changed, and this game has just gone in streaks the whole night. One team gets hot, they get a little bit of a lead. The other team gets hot, gets ahead, and it's just been like that all night long, and right now Principia is on a run.
Here's the nice thing for the Tigers. Now that Principia just took the lead, 70-69, now it's the Tigers' turn to come back, clearly on this swing of a game. It's a pendulum. It's going back and forth. Soak up. Gives it to Jones. He's around mid-range. Back to Michael. He's going to get a screen. He's going to drive in. He's going to go, and he's going to be blocked by Ross. And we're not seeing the same drive and intensity we saw from the Tigers earlier. So Principia has the ball. They have the lead by one, 70-69. Outside for Goodman. He's going to drive in. He's going for a layup. He's going to have the ball tipped away. Oh, and Singletary had the steal, but he tips it right to a Principia player, and that was Davidson. Here comes Paulson. He's going to go out. He's going to take a step-back jumper. That's going to fall. He was on the line, so it's only for two. Three-point ball game, 72-69. The Tigers need something to happen. And Coach Huseman is making an argument with the head official. Here come the Tigers. Singletary looking to drive in. Goes outside for Marquise. He gives it off. He almost lost the ball. He crosses up. He's going to go into the basket. He's going to get fouled. And that's exactly what the Tigers need to do. The foul will be going against Jeff Ross.
You know, I would imagine that Justin Ball, their 6'8 post player, is a good basketball player, Taylor, but they've played much better without him tonight. They're better off with him on the bench.
That smaller lineup has been much deadlier for him, and Marquise makes a momentum-saving play. He hits another free throw, and it's now 72-70. He almost had a turnover and then brilliantly turns it into a trip to the free throw line. He shoots another one, and it's good. He cuts it to a one-point ball game, 72-71. And Marquise will check out, and Mitch Dre coming back in.
Marquise has 13 points for the night.
Marquise has been probably their most efficient player tonight. Mitch Dre's had a bit of a struggle. He's not hitting his usual shots. They're going to bring him back in, give Marquise a little bit of a breather. So with 4.5 minutes left to play, Panthers are attacking. It's Goodman. And the ball is going to be knocked out of bounds. That will be off Steven Soakup. I thought that one was off Goodman, but the official was right on top of it. So it'll stay Panther basketball, 72-71. Principia with the lead. They inbound it to Ross. And Ross and Mitch Dre look like almost identical twins. They're built the exact same frame and almost the same height. Paulson shoots a three-pointer right in the face of Mitch Dre. He gets it to fall, 75-71. Tigers are slowing things down. 4 minutes left to play. Michael Soakup. Over to Dre. He's right at the free throw line. He goes back to Michael. Inside to Steven. He's backing down with Davidson. And now we have a foul call going against Parker Davidson. He's trying to make his case.
You know, there's no sense of making a case for a player. When you foul, get your hand up.
Just say it was you.
Just walk away.
I don't think there's ever been a time where the official goes, oh, you know what, player, you're right. Let me reverse the call
you. It's not going to get changed. Just play.
Can't you speak like someone who's been a referee before?
Yeah, I have. I've been on both sides.
And he hits his first free throw. It's now a three-point ball game, 75-72. 4:02 left to play. Second free throw rattles around. No good. It's still going to be rebounded here by Davidson. Three-point ball game. Panthers still hold the lead. Paulson guarded by Davidson, or by Butler. He gives it off to Adaku. He's going to go right in. He's going to take a short jumper. No good. Rebounded by Butler. This is the stop they need, and it's going to be taken away by Jeff Ross. Adaku gets it. Back to Ross. And now the Panthers are going to slow things down. So right when the Tigers get the break they needed, they give it right back on a poor turnover. With 3.5 minutes left, every mistake is going to be costly. Outside for Paulson. He's going right into the lane. He's going to lay it up. No good. Rebounded by Steven Sokup. He gets it to his brother, who's on the fast break. He needs to be attacking. He's going to go inside for Dre. Dre's going to be under the basket. He's going to lay it up, and he finally gets it to go. If they can get Mitch Dre heated up, we're going to have quite the ball game here.
That's his first points in the second half. Gives him 7 for the game.
75-74, our score. Panthers lead. Timeout taken on the court. Let's take one with them. 3 minutes and 6 seconds left to play. It's a one-point ball game. We'll be right back.
A fender bender can ruin anyone's day, and that's where Precision Collision comes in. They are industry experts who can get those dents out of your car and get it looking brand new again. They work hard to fix your car in a timely manner and get you back on the road. Bring your car in today and get it looking better than ever at Precision Collision at 1001 North Broadway in Mount Pleasant.
Contaminants like lead, arsenic, and nitrates can get into your home's water supply, but those with a Culligan drinking water system don't have to worry. Get a Culligan drinking water system installed and get peace of mind for pennies a day.
Celebrate Culligan's 80th anniversary with the $8.80 installation celebration. Call 319-988-1988 or go to veteranscoliganwater.com.
Contaminants may not be in your water.
Each body is different and has different needs. Without drugs or surgery, Mount Pleasant Chiropractic can help. If your body is unbalanced, you can feel pain. Chiropractic care is important to caring for a number of spinal issues. It is safe, simple, and effective. Feel better naturally. Looking for relief or total body wellness? Book an appointment at Mount Pleasant Chiropractic, 385-3000.
Welcome back, folks. One-point ball game. 3 minutes left to play. Panthers have it. Paulson, guarded by Butler. They're at the top of the key. He's going to have to pass it off now. He gets it to Adaku. Adaku's had a quick trigger finger so far tonight. Another go in for Goodman. Goodman's under the basket. He's going to lay it up. No good. Rebounded by Dre. He had great defense on that drive. So now the Tigers have the ball back. Michael Sokup has it. He's directing traffic. He's picked up by Paulson. He gets a screen from Dre. He's going to go outside for his brother Steven. Steven's going to go right in, and he will be fouled. And that one going against Trey Goodman. And you see the great chemistry and camaraderie of this Tigers team. Brock Butler sprints over to help his teammate up. And going to the line will be Steven Sokup. And he can take the lead back. 2 minutes and 29 seconds left in the ball game. He hits his first one, so we're tied up 75 points. And Coach Huseman is really sticking to the small core of players that usually starts. He has a starting five, and then Singletary, and even Austin Walker's coming a little bit. Elijah Johnson has. We've even seen a teeny bit of Jordan Nutt, but he's usually starting right now is top five players. So he hits the second free throw, 76-75. A little over 2 minutes left to play. Paulson dribbling in, spin move. He's going to lay it up. He's going to get it to fall. Back to the Panthers, 77-76. Michael Sokup gives it over to Singletary. And he's dribbling down. He's going to go into the hole. He's looking for a shot. He's going to put one up. No good. And the rebound's going to be going to Davidson. And Singletary, I think, was trying to get another foul. But at this point in the game, you can't be going for the fouls. You got to be going for the good shots. So now we're under 2 minutes. Panthers lead by one. Paulson is going to drive in. He had a shot, but he likes not to take it. He almost lost the handle there. And there's going to be a traveling call. And that's a costly turnover for the Panthers. And Michael Paulson not happy with himself after that one. So the Tigers have the ball with a minute 43 left to play. They are down by one. inbound to Singletary, who gets it right back to Michael Soka. Panthers, this half, have really abandoned the full court trap. There goes a screen outside. Steven Soka, he shoots a three-pointer. It's going to rattle around. No good. And the ball's going to be last touch. And they're going to say by Singletary. And I don't think that call is correct. That one was clearly touched by Parker Davidson. And I think the officials are going to have to talk this over. No, they're not going to talk it over. So they're going to say it was out on C.J. Singletary. That could be a huge call in this ball game. One-point ball game, 76-77. Tigers trail. Paulson outside for Goodman. He's going to be dribbling in. He's going for a shot. He's going to be fouled, and he makes the and one. So Trey Goodman coming up clutch here in the second half can really put the nail in the coffin. Make it a four-point ball game if he hits this one.
Goodman's got 14 points, looking for 15 all in the second half.
He has been the spark that the Panthers needed. Coach Huseman has to be furious about that call. Checking back in, Marquise Jones. He's coming in for, I believe, Steven Soakup. No, I believe it's Michael Soakup. It's hard to tell with those identical twins. So Goodman has a chance to make it a two-possession game. We have a minute 14 left to play. It's up, and he does. So now 80-76. Tigers were in a key spot to win it, and now they're going to have to come up with some late-game heroics. Singletary to Marquise. Out to Dre. Over to Butler. He's at half court, and he's guarded by Paulson. He gets the screen. He's going right into the hole. He's going to lay it up, and that's going to go down. So Brock Butler gets a great ball and a great layup to fall. It's now a two-point game. We're going to stay here during the timeout. 59.8 seconds left to play. The Panthers are going to get the ball back. Now, Kent, if you're coaching the Tigers, what's the situation? What are you telling them right now?
Well, you just got to play good defense, and there's still plenty of time. There's a minute left in this game, and they're going to have the ball at least two more times. And they got to play good defense right now. And even if Principia comes down and scores, it's a two-point play. They're just only down one possession. So they just got to be patient, take the good shot. First good shot that comes up, if it's a three, it's a three. If it's a two, it's a two. But take the good shot and make sure the ball is in the hands of the players that you want it in. And I'm talking about probably in this situation, Butler and the two Sokas.
That's what I would go with exactly. The big-time players and big-time moments. So the Tigers trailing 80-78, less than a minute to play here. The Tigers will have the ball. Or no, they're going to be defending the ball. And Principia typically doesn't score this well. They average 70 points a game. But the Tiger defense, they average allowing 87 points a game. So you're five on the court for Iowa Wesleyan. Marquise Jones, Mitchell Dre, Brock Butler, C.J. Singletary, and Steven Soakup.
This is one of those games where you hate to see one of these two teams lose. And one of them's going to lose. And you just hope it's Principia, not the Tigers.
Absolutely. Inbounding, Davidson. He gets it over to Paulson, who's guarded by Brock Butler. Butler is going to try playing some smothering defense. See if he can stay in front of him. He gets a screen by Goodman. He goes outside for Goodman. Goodman's going to go in. He's been great this half, and he's going to lay it up. That's going to be no good. And then rebounded by Goodman again. So now it's a four-point ball game, 82-78 on a mistimed jump by Brock Butler. He could have had the rebound and more. And now here comes Michael Soakup. He's going to lay it down. He's fouled hard, that one against Jeff Ross. And Ross is trying to tell his teammates what happened there. So shooting two will be Steven Soakup with 36.6 seconds. These are key free throws. You have to hit them both, or at least one to make it a three-point ball game.
Steven looking for point number 24 and 25.
He hits the first one. It's a three-point ball game, 82-79. And he's settling in for the second. It's up, and it's good. So clutch free throws here, two-point ball game. And we see a full-court press coming for the Tigers. They're trying to get Paulson. Mitch Dre is running him down, and they're going to foul him immediately. And with 32 seconds, you don't agree with the call there, Kent.
No, sure don't. You got plenty of time.
That's true. You're only down by two, so Paulson will go to the line. Let's look at his free throws in the game. He didn't shoot any in that first half. You have to imagine if they're giving him the ball, he has a pretty decent free throw performance. He shoots it up, and it rattles around, no good. So it's going to stay a one-possession game no matter what. 82-80, Paulson. He can make it a three-point ball game if he hits it here. If not, the Tigers are in a good spot. It's up, and it's good. So three-point ball game. Dre gives it over to Butler. And we've seen him make some big shots in his time here at Iowa Wesleyan. Outside for Mitch Dre. He's going to go inside. Outside again for Sokup. To Butler. He's going to go around the arch. They have about 15 seconds on the shot clock. They got to get something off here.
They're guarding the arc.
Outside. Here comes the shot. That's going to be no good. That's going to be rebounded by the Panthers. They're going to foul Goodman. Or they got to catch up to Goodman. So not the prettiest of shots there for Steven Sokup. It looked like it might have fallen for a second.
That's one of those defensive stance, great by Principia, because they were guarding the arc. They were preventing the three. Wesleyan should have been happy to take the two inside. And they still had 18 seconds on the clock. So they took the three. They missed it. So hopefully Goodman's going to miss at the free throw line. And so far this evening, he shot 5 out of 6. So it wasn't the right person to foul.
He got the rebound, and he misses his first one. So they're still alive in this ball game. 6.9 seconds left. Goodman has got to feel all the pressure in the world right now. If he can hit it, he pretty much seals the win. If he misses it, he gives the Tigers a second chance at life. And he does miss it. It's going to be rebounded by Jones. They're going to be pushing it to Singletary. Singletary does not shoot. He gives it to Butler, who shoots, and it's up. And it rattles around. No good. So they lose on the last shot of the ball game. And the Panthers will win their second conference game of the season. Tigers lose their first conference game of the season. They improve, or they fall to 4-4. And Principia goes to 3-4. And let's take a timeout, and then we'll be back with the postgame analysis.